Welcome back. We're here to talk about Monday night's match between Stoke and Chelsea. Start with the visitors, Pascal. Return to winning ways against Hull last time out.
Yeah, obviously the defeat to Newcastle the previous week in the Premier League would have been really disappointing because it was their first loss of the season. Obviously everyone talking about whether they could go all season unbeaten, but it wasn't to be. And yeah, the home game against Hull, everyone would have expected them to win that game. Hull came into that really bad form and obviously Chelsea back at home really expected to win that. And they did 2-0, the classic Mourinho performance at Stamford Bridge really. Hazard and Costa with the goals, yeah, you know, they're two superstars up front. But unfortunately the headlines weren't about Chelsea offers. It was all about the referee, Chris Foy, and his decisions, because he booked Costa for diving but then decided not to book Cahill when it was another clear dive. He didn't give a penalty either, and you just wonder if he bottled it a bit because Cahill was already on a yellow card and should have been sent off. So Mourinho would have been pleased with the win but disappointed at the headlines afterwards.
Yeah, there was a controversial decision in midweek as well. Chelsea in action in the League Cup against Derby. Derby had a man sent off just when it looked like they might be getting back into the match. They pulled a goal back to make it 2-1. And we're putting Chelsea under a bit of pressure. Chelsea did end up winning the game 3-1 there. Quite comfortable victory in the end. But Mourinho won't be happy with how he let Derby back into the match because they were looking in complete control at 2-0. And it does show that he named a strong side to keep them in contention for four trophies this season. But it does show the strength and depth that he made. I think it was 5 changes. And they still look pretty good against the Derby side. It was a tricky match against the Ipo. They're doing very well in the Championship. Could well be a Premier League fixture next season. So to be able to rest players and get that came at a bit of a cost. You know, Drogba and Zouma both went off with injuries, but neither of them would be in the starting 11, so that shouldn't affect them this weekend. But all in all, another good victory for them.
Yeah, and you mentioned the red card there. There was also a red card in the whole game. And, you know, I look at their team, they're quite a mean team. Like, a lot of characters, obviously Costa we know about. He ruffles up defenders all the time. Against Sunderland, he sort of elbowed players twice and got away with it, really. He only got booked for the, you know, 2 challenges he made in that game, so. And yeah, you look at other players. Fabregas is a sort of midfielder. He looks really pretty all the time, but he makes a lot of little tackles here and there that would just annoy players. Costa's going to annoy players. And I look at their outfit and you think, you know, with their sort of game plan, they'll sort of ruffle the feathers of opponents and maybe take their opponents' eye off the ball on their game plan. And yeah, if you've got that and all the talent as well, they just look like such a mean outfit at the moment.
If any side can stand up to them physically, though, it would be Stoke probably. They played that way probably more under Pulis than they do under Hughes, though, but they've still got that physical edge to them, and they showed that in the draw against Crystal Palace last time out. Did well to respond straight away. They went behind, I think it was in the 11th minute, and equalised in the 13th. Peter Crouch with a tap-in from close range. He's been an important player for them this season, and his contract runs out soon, so he's probably playing for his own future there. He said he's not going to retire, and I'm sure there won't be any shortage of clubs looking for him, so they'll fancy keeping him, and if he can keep on showing them that they should. Bojan has also been another important player for them. He went off injured in that match against Crystal Palace, so he's a doubt, which is a big blow for this weekend. But Crouch is probably the main danger man they'll be looking to.
Definitely. I do wonder, though, if this is as good as it will get this season. They're up to 12th in the table, and I look at all the sides above them, and I just wonder if Stoke can actually finish above any of them, because you've got sort of the big 7 clubs, and then you've got Southampton, Newcastle, Swansea, you know, all those sides. They look probably a bit stronger than Stoke. So even though Stoke have done all right recently, up to 12th in the table, I do sort of wonder if it can get any better than this, or if they're just going to sort of stay around sort of 12th, 13th, 14th all season.
What's your score prediction for this one?
Yeah, obviously, Chelsea are going to start the game as big favourites, aren't they? I think it'll be quite a tight game, obviously. Stoke, they haven't been as good at home this season as they usually are, so I think I'm going to back Chelsea to win 2-0.
Yeah, I think I'm going to agree with that. Chelsea seems to be their favourite margin of victory, doesn't it? 2 goals. Mourinho is very good at it. I agree with that 2-0. So both going for 2-0 Chelsea victories. Thanks for watching.